All right, speaking of birds, Kim, I understand you have a wild bird with you just in time for Thanksgiving.
Oh, that's right. We have actually two birds probably planning their own Thanksgiving. Let's start with Roger Holloway, Director of Operations at World Bird Sanctuary. He has Liberty here with him. Can you tell us a little bit about how the bald eagle came to be our national symbol?
The bald eagle became our national symbol in 1782. Our founding fathers recognized it as a very graceful and powerful bird that was unique to the new land and new country they had founded. And with their ability to soar overhead and their very noticeable white head and tail, they're just a very regal bird. And so that became our national symbol.
I agree. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for coming to visit us, Miss Liberty. Mr. Liberty. Sorry,
it's
Mr.
Okay.
Liberty. I apologize. Now we have Ben Montgomery, Program Director, World Bird Sanctuary. So, it's turkey week, but that's a turkey vulture.
That's right. We couldn't bring you a turkey.
But that's okay. But that one's not ending up on anybody's table.
No, certainly not. But it's going to help all of us have a very clean planet. So we're very thankful that turkey vultures help us to keep a balanced and clean environment.
So what do turkey vultures eat?
Turkey vultures will eat just about anything,
okay,
as long as it's already dead.
Okay, good.
But they have stomach fluids that are so acidic that they are a dead end for disease. So even though there are many animals that are scavengers, only turkey vultures help us keep a clean planet.
Oh, okay. All right. So they're considered birds of prey, not quite as graceful as the bald eagle, but they definitely help us have some really nice surroundings.
Perhaps not as good looking as the bald eagle, but still pretty special.
And what's this bird's name?
This is Kinsey.
Kinsey. Girl or boy?
Boy.
Boy. I think Kinsey's very, very handsome. I think absolutely handsome. I do know that we do have the holiday coming up, but you guys have a lot of really cool stuff going on year round. I know you guys have the owl prowls. What else do you guys have?
Yeah, owl prowls are throughout the winter all the way to March. In the middle of December, I think it's on the 15th, we have Christmas is for the Birds,
really?
Which is a really fun way to combine our holiday with all the birds that we have there.
Yeah.
And then January starts off with Eagle Days, and we celebrate the return of the bald eagle to our region in the winter months.
How do people prepare for Eagle Days? Because, I mean, they can bring binoculars, but they need to dress warm. I mean, this is an event that families go to every year, right?
Yeah, right. And it's a great time to be outdoors in the winter and to get out and see our beautiful region, our rivers, and look for the eagles fishing.
Yeah.
And swooping down on the river to get their food.
All right, everybody. Well, let's go ahead and get ready for an entire holiday season that's going to the birds. The World Bird Sanctuary is at 125 Bald Eagle Ridge Road in Valley Park. Just call 636-225-4390 or visit worldbirdsanctuary.org. One represents our country and the other keeps our country clean here on the 9 a.m. show. The Poor warms up for their Toys for Tots set at Tops. And Carol Hurst warms up the stuffing or dressing argument at the Old Town Spice Shop.